Good morning, everyone. Welcome to worship on this Easter season as we go through our series, Dare to Dance Again. And so we invite you to join in singing Dare to Dance Again as we receive this threshold moment.
Easter is the unstoppable, unpredictable expression of God's love for humankind. The call of Jesus is to live fully in the power of that love, alive in each of us. We learn about that divine love as it is embodied in the person and ministry of Jesus, the one who is compared to a good shepherd.
Dare to dance with dreamers, sing their song. Dare to dance their story, sing out strong. Dare to dance with freedom your whole life long. Dare to dance again.
As we look to Jesus to learn how to love, may our hearts praise the one who raised Jesus and raises us to abundant life and love. For if we are to dance with abandon, we learn and follow. Then we can begin to lead. We can learn the steps to the dance of love through the lead of Jesus and those who have gone before us. May we dare to dance even as we continue to learn the way of love.
Dare to dance with dreamers, sing their song. Dare to dance their story, sing out strong. Dare to dance with freedom your whole life long. Dare to dance again.
This is the call. We lean into this day with the strength we have. We lift up our heads to meet the day. God sends out a call that will not let us go. We fortify our hearts with compassion and action. If rain still lingers, open the umbrellas of love and set out anyway. For we are called to dance again.
Christ is risen. I invite you to join me in prayer. Holy One, Justice Seeker, Lover of Creation, we know your voice, the sounds of your steps. Your love gathers us, urges us, encourages us. Come and dance with us. Engage us as we seek you, so that we can be risen with Christ and in Christ. Be with us now, we pray. Amen. May the peace of the risen Christ be with you. You're invited to turn to the people around you and wave as a sign of grace-filled greetings this day. Yep, hi to everybody on camera too. Our scripture today is from the 10th chapter of John, verses 11 through 17. I am the good shepherd. The good shepherd lays down his life for the sheep. The hired hand is not the shepherd and does not own the sheep. So when he sees the wolf coming, he abandons the sheep and runs away. Then the wolf attacks the flock and scatters it. The man runs away because he is a hired hand and cares nothing for the sheep. I am the good shepherd. I know my sheep and my sheep know me, just as the Father knows me and I know the Father, and I lay down my life for the sheep. I have other sheep that are not of this sheep pen. I must bring them also. They too will listen to my voice, and there shall be one flock and one shepherd. The reason for my Father loves me is that I lay down my life, only to take it up again. From the third chapter of 1 John, verses 16 to 18 and 23 to 24. This is how we know what love is. Jesus Christ laid down his life for us. And we ought to lay down our lives for our brothers and sisters. If anyone has material possessions and sees a brother or sister in need, but has no pity on them, how can the love of God be in that person? Dear children, let us not love with words or speech, but with actions and in truth. And this is his command, to believe in the name of his Son, Jesus Christ, and to love one another as he commanded us. The one who keeps God's commands lives in him, and he in them. And this is how we know that he lives in us. We know it by the Spirit he gave us. The word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God. Earth Day was this past Thursday. If you had your TV turned on to the news at all, likely you saw some special features about Earth Day. I remember the first Earth Day. It was April 22nd, 1970. I was in fifth grade that year. I know we spent probably more than just that day talking about the Earth and the issues of pollution. It came about partly because of things like, well, the previous year on June 22nd, the Cuyahoga River turned into a river of fire due to the spark of a passing train, lighting all of the oil slick that was on the river on fire. Across the last 50 years, we've heard terms like global warming, global cooling, and climate change. There is an ongoing debate about whether climate change is 100% naturally occurring or whether human activity has any effect on it at all. And my suspicion is that, like many things in life, we may have differing opinions even within this group. Our featured dreamer today is a young woman who stirred up the environmental conversation last year by the name of Greta Thunberg. Greta is from Sweden. Her biggest dream is that the leaders of the world would take action to stop or slow down climate change and take care of planet Earth. Now, Greta's bad dream is that no one is going to do anything about climate change. And so she started talking about those fears and trying to make a difference, you know, with her dreams of a healthy environment. She shared her dreams first with her parents and then eventually made signs and stood outside of government buildings. She shared her dream with other children and youth and young adults, many from all over the world, causing it to become their dreams too. Now, I don't know if Greta has all the science right, but here's what I do know. As a scout, I learned that when we go camping, we should leave no trace. I learned that we should take everything out that we brought in with us. As a scout, I learned that when we go camping, I ought to leave the place looking better than it did when I first got there. As a Christian, Genesis teaches me that God has assigned us to be stewards of God's creation. In other words, we're supposed to take care of it. And as a human, I have learned that I like the taste of fresh water that doesn't have to go through treatment before I can drink it. And I, as a human, have learned that I like the smell of fresh air that isn't filled with all kinds of other smells. And as a human, I find it exciting to walk into a natural area that is absolute pristine beauty, uncluttered by litter. And while it may seem unfair that I have to clean up after past generations, honestly, I still like that thought better than to leave it to my granddaughter to have to clean up after me. So perhaps some of Greta's dreams are my dreams too. What will we be known for? Do we dream big dreams? Do we seek our dreams, even while others may laugh and criticize us? What will we be known for? How do we know the rhythm and dance of our lives is faithful? Well, Mickey Hart, the drummer of the Grateful Dead, wrote once, "To fall in love is to fall in rhythm." To fall in love is to fall in rhythm. If that's true, then how can we listen to music that draws us together, that we might fall in rhythm with our neighbor, so that we might build up the whole of our community? In the 10th chapter of John, Jesus tells us that he is the good shepherd. He goes on to explain how a good shepherd is known. He also tells us the difference of how a hired hand is known. Jesus goes on to say that he knows his sheep and his sheep know him. They know his love and care. And as the good shepherd, Jesus will lay down his life for his sheep. The first letter of John picks that theme up and reminds us that we should be known for that kind of love, just as Jesus laid down his life for us out of love, that we too should be ready to lay down our lives for others. We lay down our life for others, not by simply giving up our life, but by how we live our lives each and every day. We're called to love not simply with words or speech, but with actions and with truth. We're to believe in the name of Jesus, and we are to love one another as he commanded us. We live in the midst of a self-centered world that fosters an attitude of everyone for themselves. And in the midst of that world, Christians ought to be the ones who are known by our love. Our colorful rainbow, umbrella rainbows are a sign of joy and hope even on a rainy day. And we likewise are meant to be a sign of joy and hope in the midst of the world by our love. Our featured dance of this week is in honor of Earth Day, and the words will appear. You're welcome to sing along, but more importantly, pay attention to the pictures. They go with the words so very well.
Dance with the Spirit early in the morning. Walk with the Spirit throughout the long day. Work and hope for the new life upon, and listen to the Spirit to show you the way.
Dance with the Spirit early in the morning. Walk with the Spirit throughout the long day.
To dance with the Spirit. This is the dance of love to which we are invited, that we may be known as Christians by our love. Let us pray. We offer thanks for Dreamers True, for all they are and all they do. Let us become dreamers too, and bring new life to me and you. Amen. Part of our offering goes to support the mission and ministry of the United Methodist Church. What do these funds do? Well, about two-thirds of our apportionment stay in Western Pennsylvania. Today, I want to share another video on one of the five focus areas as we learn more about engaging in ministry with the poor.
Almost 40 million people are living in poverty. That's nearly one-eighth of the population living on less than $26,000 a year for a family of four. Poverty used to be more of an inner city phenomenon, but as housing costs skyrocketed, poverty exploded in the suburbs. Now there are 3 million more poor people in suburbs than cities.
Tonight in a special report, we're taking a closer look at a growing problem across America.
Smaller, locally owned grocery stores are closing their doors, and it looks like that problem could be getting worse. Beth Naylor explains now how this could be affecting your community. Beth?
Mike Mariel, lack of fresh food is a problem that affects tens of thousands of people all across our region. And we found out that the communities hit the hardest are communities where that fresh food is actually grown. It's a growing issue that's sort of hidden in plain sight. By some accounts, 98% of all food deserts reside in non-metropolitan areas. A 2013 study found nearly 30 million Americans reside in them. According to the U.S. Department of Agriculture, there are dozens of both urban and rural food deserts in northwestern Pennsylvania, and that number appears to be growing.
Welcome to the Pharmacy Desert, the place in major American cities where garbage lies strewn like urban tumbleweeds before what used to be corner drugstores. It's a growing phenomenon in poor minority neighborhoods across the United States. Report, the Kane District Ramp Ministry has been building those with disabilities ramps for several years, and their workforce is continuing to grow.
We're the hands of God, doing God's work, you know, providing the resources, and He's directing us.
The Kane District Ramp Ministry helps those in seven different counties who need ramps to get in and out of their houses, a labor of love for anyone willing to help.
We've got buckets, and in these buckets are CDC-recommended supplies that families need to protect themselves from COVID-19. EUMA served 166 households last year, moving them from homelessness into permanent housing, and we are coming alongside of these families to help them protect themselves from COVID-19.
Every time I try to make it on my own, Every time I try to stand, start to fall. And all those lonely roads that I've traveled on, there was Jesus. When the life I built came crashing to the ground, when the friends I had were nowhere to be found, I couldn't see it then, but I can see it. There was Jesus. In the way, in the searching, in the healing, in the hurting, like a blessing buried in the broken pieces. Every minute, every moment, where I've been or where I'm going, even when I didn't know it or couldn't see it, so I thank God every day. Well, there was Jesus.
There was Jesus.
In the way, in the searching, in the healing, in the hurting, like a blessing buried in broken pieces. Every minute, every moment, where I've been or where I'm going, shadows of the alley.
To not just be set apart on the hillside, but really be in ministry with the community.
Through your gifts, through your treasures, your talent, your time, so many ministries that we're able to support. Thank you for your continued faithfulness in supporting the ministries of our churches, because we are the hands and feet of Christ in our community, across Western Pennsylvania, and all around the world. Thank you for who you are and for what you do. So what would your life look like if you saw each day to dance the dance of love, to dance to the rhythm of the love of God moving in our lives? May we hear the music of the Spirit and follow in the steps of Jesus, who love set us free to dance with abandonment. Receive now this blessing. May the loving God, the risen Christ, and the dancing Spirit fill you with all you need for the days ahead. And all of God's people said, amen. Go in peace.